In this video, we will demonstrate how to use the Dixon DX60 series hygienic tanker valve. To start, remove the aluminum dust cover from the valve. Next, remove the bevel seat nut using a 3-inch bevel seat hex nut wrench. Connect the hose to the valve and thread the nut onto the threaded bevel seat connection on the valve. Tighten the hex nut with the 3-inch bevel seat hex nut wrench used previously. To open the valve, loosen the wing nut on the hinged locking eye bolt and swing the bolt open to disengage from the opposing cam arm. Release the cam arms. Next, follow the laser mark instructions on the handle and align the arrow with the red indicator on the bonnet. Pull the plunger stem toward you to the full extension while keeping the arrow aligned with the red indicator on the bonnet. Rotate the handle until the arrow is aligned with the green indicator. Push on the handle to ensure the stem was opened properly and is locked in position. If the plunger did not lock, realign the arrow with the red indicator and repeat the previous step. The stem will remain in the locked position until the arrow on the handle aligns again with the red indicator on the bonnet. You may now load or unload through the valve. When loading or unloading of the tank is complete, close the valve. To do this, rotate the handle until the arrow aligns back to the red indicator on the bonnet. Push the stem in to close the valve and close the cam arms completely. Swing the hinged locking eye bolt over to engage in the slot on the opposing cam arm. Tighten the wing nut until secure. Remove the hose assembly and nut from the valve using the hex nut wrench. Reinstall the valve port end cap and bevel seat nut. Tighten the hex nut with the wrench and replace the dust cover on the valve. Loosen the wing nut of the body clamp and remove the body clamp. Caution, never remove the body clamp from the valve when the trailer is loaded or is in the process of being loaded or unloaded. Loss of load and injury could occur. Next, remove the plunger bonnet assembly from the valve body and inspect the valve seals and internal valve surfaces. Reinstall the plunger bonnet assembly in the valve body, being sure to align and engage the locating pin on the bonnet into the slot on the valve body flange. Install the body clamp, being sure to align the laser marked line on the clamp with the green indicator.